promise you that your peace of mind will be back because you will only focus on positive things. Guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Akanksha and I do fashion, beauty and lifestyle. Today's video is going to be a very sensitive topic. You already have seen from the caption, it's about mental health. And why I thought of talking about it now, because right now is a situation where a lot of people are finding it difficult to, you know, get into the right set of mind and to have their peace of mind. So I am going to share one of my stories, my experience with mental health, and it's a very short story that I'm going to tell. I'm not going in deep too much, but I promise you that the end is going to be really happy. So stay tuned and watch till the end. Without talking much, I'm going to jump to my story and my experience with mental health, and in the end section I'm going to talk about how I came out of it and what are the things you need to take care of. I came to Bangalore in 2013. My home is in Jammu, and right after my college I came here to came with my college friends, my group. And after coming here I was very excited क्योंकि मुझे वो independent वाला life जीना था और मुझे मतलब वो सब कुछ experience करना था जो आप parents के साथ रह के आपको पता है कि यार you are depending on your papa या आपके mama पे की wanted to be on my own, cook my own food, learn how to cook, shop for myself, learn to earn money and be really independent. So I was happy, excited, and after we had a lot of fun, we all friends, we were like exploring the city, and to be honest I love Bangalore. But then I started my job. Within 3 months I got my job after training, and I was liking it for a few months, but then after that I realized that I was taking a lot of stress, and because of that I felt weak physically. I did not know what is happening because I literally left the things I used to do which used to make me happy. So, and I was not even interested. I love shopping, I love to dress up. I was not doing any of it, and even I was not eating food also. It was like I'm not interested in anything. I don't want to go out. Sometimes I will make some plans, I'll cancel it because I'm sad suddenly. So I was very confused. I could not figure out what is happening. Honestly, I did not seek any help. I had my friends, my family, that help. If you have your loved ones around you or even they are talking to you, love helps a lot and support of family helps a lot. But if in some circumstances you don't have that kind of support, don't be disappointed, because I'm going to tell you in the end that how can you be happy alone on your own self. So then I started observing things about myself which I did not for a few months when I was in stress and stuff like that. I ignored my health, I ignored myself. I started forcing myself to do the things I used to love. Just imagine, I was forcing to do it. But then gradually you have to push yourself to do what makes you happy. So I started shopping, I started spending time with my friends, with Ankush, with my family. I used to go to my hometown in vacations and all. I was like coming back to the state where I wanted to, but then again it was not fully me. I could not recognize who I was. Then I realized after 1.5 years in my job, I thought maybe it's time to change my job, like change, because I'm in IT. I thought I'll just change my company, and I did. Luckily I got an offer and I changed my company. It was better money, new environment, new people. I tried to make some friends. I thought maybe this is going to help me, but then again 3-4 months after I realized that it's not helping me, I'm again taking stress and I'm sad for no reason. I could not think of anything else, but then again I pushed myself. I thought, you know, I have to give myself some time, so I started taking leaves. Even if I don't have to go to Jammu, I would take leaves and I will give time to myself, go to movies, to eat something, whatever that makes me happy, and food actually makes me happy. So I started doing that. I lost a lot of weight also in that phase, but it is not in a good sense. So that was really bad. But then that phase was just for, you know, 1.5 or maybe near to 2 years. After that I came back on my track, because I actually figured out what is the problem, because I was away from family, I was missing them maybe, and but I could not know what is happening, and the new life, maybe the change was the reason. And maybe sometimes when you're alone, you don't know what to do because you're always habitual of having family around. So this was the journey. You must be thinking it's not that painful, but I would just give you examples. I used to cry without any reason. Everything was good, everything was happening in my way, the things I would have wanted, everything was happening in that way. And but still I was sad. I think that time I could not love myself. That was the reason. I would feel ugly, I would feel worthless, that, you know, what is my purpose? And I was thinking too much. And that was one. And then second thing was, in that phase I lost you know, my good friends, my old friends. I just stopped talking to them all of a sudden. There was some few things which happened, but it was not that big that I would, you know, not talk to them like my entire life. So that happened, and but I moved on. But I still have my family with me, Ankush with me, so for me that is very important. But that was the phase, and I'm not at all shy to share about this, because some people might feel, you know, aisa hua tha, we should not tell people what people will think. Not something that you should be shy of telling people, because if you share your experience with people, you never know, the next person you are telling this to might be feeling the same, and he would realize what is happening and it might help. That was my experience and that was my story. First thing is, you have to know what is happening. So you have to know yourself. It might look selfish to others when you are so much indulging with your own self, spending time with your own self and knowing yourself, but it is very important. It's not at all selfish, because mental health, your physical health, your health comes first. Your peace of mind is the most important thing. Peace of mind is not there, I don't think you can even make somebody else happy. So you have to make yourself happy first, and then you can, you know, make your surroundings and everybody around you happy. Second thing is, while I was observing, I found the causes. I thought maybe the job is not right. I thought I'm not doing what I love. I thought I'm not interested, so I have to push myself. So I left my job, I got into another. I changed my environment, basically finding the root causes and working upon it. And the third thing is to love yourself. Love yourself unlimited. The fourth thing is, which is very ajeeb sa hai, jo main bolungi, but ek bari lifetime mein karna bahut zaruri hai. When you feel you're afraid of something, because depression happens, anxiety happens when you know, are afraid of something, face that fear once in your lifetime, and you will never feel that kind of, you know, that level of fearness or sadness again in your life. Even if you feel that, you know how to handle it. Next thing that I'm going to tell is, be positive, be optimistic, and always have hope. When you are in that mental state where you're not able to love yourself, where you don't know what is happening, you tend to lose hope. If you believe in God, then nothing like it, because when you know that there is a higher power, you will always know whatever happens, it's for the best, and that actually keeps you going. So pray, meditate if you can. That is very important, to be in that positive state of mind and have a good vibe. So that I will definitely suggest. Talk to your family, don't hide anything. Always be very open about what you're feeling, what you're thinking. They might think, or you might think, that, you know, I'm just telling my problems, but it's fine. You have to seek help, and everybody around you who loves you will help you. Last thing, which is the best thing, jo maine khud se realize kara hai, it's a very small thing, but agar aap socho, to you will never have that, you know, phase of anxiety or depression or any mental health issue. Jabhi bhi main kisi problem mein hoti hu ya jabhi mujhe lagta hai ki, you know, worst might happen, always think ki why I am ruining my present because of something which might happen in future. This is the first thing, which is very basic. But then second thing jo main sochti hu wo ye hai, in case you are getting negative thoughts or you are fearing about something, always think कि ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा क्या हो जाएगा, ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा कुछ नहीं हो सकता, ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा there is only one thing, that the life will end. But till the time you have this life, you have your body, you have your own self, be it anything, even if you don't have anyone around and you're alone, still you have your life and you have this chance, and you will always have yourself with you. Why you need support of others? I'm not telling that, you know, you don't need anybody else. You will, because we are living in an ecosystem and we need help. But sometimes you have to make peace with your own self and just be strong that, you know, you can be on your own. You came alone and you're going to go alone. So don't depend on a lot of people. Yes, you need help, take help. You need support, take support. But don't depend on people. Always do your own thing. So that's all about the video. And I want to end this video on a note that you have this life, one life. We don't know about Purana Janam, Aane Wala Janam. It might happen, but right now you have this chance. Why not make this life worth living for? That's all, and think about it. And I hope this helped you in some way. And you can connect to me on Instagram at akanksha_youtube, and you can DM me there, you can comment here, like, share, subscribe, and do hit that notification bell icon so that you know whenever I upload a video. And be happy and take care. Bye.